Hi there, this is Marlene Christensen from Denmark. And have you ever felt like you were just in a business slump and you felt totally unmotivated to move forward? Today, I'm going to share 10 strategies with you on how to fix that immediately. Number one goal. Have just one big goal. Whenever I've been in a slump, I've discovered that it's often because I have too much going on in my life. I'm trying to do too much and it kind of saps my energy and my motivation because it's all like, when you don't focus, it's like watered down. So it's not a strong motivation. It's not filled with energy because it's just watered down to fit all of the projects. So it's a very common mistake that people make, trying to do too much at a time. So have you ever heard that saying about you can do much less in 1 month that you think, but you can do so much more in 1 year that you think? So it starts with having a focus, having a goal, and just go after that until you complete it, then choose another one. Yeah, you cannot you cannot maintain energy and focus if you're trying to do more than one goal at a time. Maximum two goals in different areas, and it's not possible. I've tried many times, and you just have to choose one goal for now. Stick with it until you reach it, after you reach it, you have to celebrate. It's really important to keep motivated by celebrating. And it doesn't have to be a very big goal that takes a year to fulfill. Break it down into small steps so you can celebrate often. It will keep you motivated high, your motivation high as well. And you also try to evaluate how you're moving forward on that goal every day. And also check in if this goal is realistic, if it's the main thing, the big needle mover for now. If not, you are permitted to change the goal, but don't change it into three other goals, change it into one other goal. So you still only at one point in time have one big goal. Number two, get excited. It sounds so obvious, but most people don't think about it much. If you want to break out of a slump, you need to get excited about your goal. But how can you do that if you don't feel motivated? Well, it starts with inspiration from others. Go check out other people who have want to accomplish the same thing, maybe on YouTube or in your group of friends, maybe on Facebook. And don't get sucked into all the social media hype. Just stay on course, focus on your goal. Research what makes other people excited about that kind of goal. And for me, I've learned that talking to my friends in the mastermind group that I'm part of, that gets me excited to kind of remind myself of why I'm doing what I'm doing. And other people are like, yeah, they want the same thing and we can get excited together. And masterminding is really great for that. So if you don't have any friends that are excited about the same thing, go try and find a group on Facebook with people with similar interests. You'll see it works like magic. And yeah, when you're excited about your goal, you just put more energy and focus into it. And nothing will keep you stuck after that. It will completely take you out of your slump and keep you motivated. Number three. Now, this strategy is a little bit hard. And many people will skip this and not find it tempting. Or attractive, but it's really important and it really works. Now, before I found this strategy, I used to set myself a goal, like a weight loss goal or wanting to exercise or something. And I'm going to start right away and just go right ahead and lose interest. And the chances of success was actually very slim. Now, After I found this strategy, I set myself a goal of wanting to lose weight fast and I wanted to do a 10-day water fast. Now, I found out that building anticipation will increase the energy and the motivation for reaching my goal. So what I did was I put it out in the calendar, 2 weeks out in the calendar. And so I had something to look forward to, just like Christmas. You know it's coming, but it's not quite there. And you have to buy the gifts and you have to get all the ornaments and the decorations ready and stuff like that. And you're building anticipation. So what I did, I was, okay, I have to quit coffee to do this. So I took a week quitting coffee. Oh, it's almost there. And then I quit sugar for a week, no more sugar, and doing light fasting. So I was almost there, but not enough. And finally, the day arrived where I started my 10-day fast, and I was so ready, and I did it. So building anticipation and not starting right away and making sure every detail is in place for you to succeed, that really helps with your motivation and with getting you out of a slump. Number four. Post your goal. Now, this strategy is something that is taught quite often, and it has to do with you seeing your goal all the time. So what it actually means is that you print out your goal, stated in like exercise 15 minutes daily, or going on a water fast, and having it placed somewhere that you see it every day. Someone told me that they wrote it on the mirror, and another one told me that they had like an alarm going off on their mobile phone, reminding them of their goal. And another way is to post it online to make it public, and just always reminding yourself of whatever goal you have can really motivate you, and it can pull you out of a slump. Number five, get support. Now, this strategy is for some people obvious, and for others really, really hard. This thing by reaching out to others, getting help. For me, it's been a journey, but I've learned to reach out and get the support that I need. I have learned to tell my friends and my family, this is what I'm doing and you can support me in this way. And I have learned to reach out online to communities, to Facebook groups, and find people who have the similar goals and who wants to support each other. Now, sometimes you get in a group where it's not quite the right fit. You can kind of like feel that the energy is not right for you, but there are tons of places to go online. You just have to search a little bit and you will find a place where others are like-minded and the energy fits wherever you are. So get support. That is one of the best strategies you can implement for getting out of a slump and getting motivated. Number six, motivation and energy comes in an ebb and flow. Realizing this is a very good strategy for not getting in a slump. And it's like energy in your body. When you fill it up with water and good food and stuff like that, you feel a lot of energy, but then you have to go to sleep when all of that energy has been used up. So it's a natural pattern, up and down with the motivation. So just stick with it. Don't get into blaming yourself if your motivation isn't that high. Another thing is that for some people, the motivation is high in the morning, and for some others, it's high in the evening. So finding out what kind of person you are and doing the things that are the big needle movers, the going after your goal in that time frame, whether it's in the morning or in the evening, realizing that your energy goes up and down, and just say to yourself, I'm going to schedule out in an hour in the morning or an hour in the evening to work on this goal, because that's where I know that my energy is the highest and my motivation is highest. Realizing that ebb and flow, that would really put you out, you know, get you out of a slump and motivate you. Number seven, start really, really small. Now, this strategy is I learned this the hard way. I am kind of like the person who wants to build the biggest vase in the ceramic shop, taking my first class. I just want it to be perfect. And well, life doesn't work that way. sometimes we're having a hard time getting started on something new because maybe we are thinking way too big. I don't mean having a big goal is wrong. It's just the next thing you need to focus on to reach your goal can be a bit too big. So if you, for example, want to exercise, you might be thinking that you need to do this high intensity training 5 days a week to get into shape. No. Instead, focus on baby steps. Just do like start with, if you have never worked out, start with like doing 2 minutes of exercise or maybe 5 days a week, or maybe you would rather do 15 minutes every third day. Just start with a commitment to a small step and you will find out that you will actually move along quicker and stay the course instead of giving up because you had too high expectations from the beginning. So that will keep you motivated and get you out of that slump. Number 8, think about the benefits and not the difficulties. A common problem that I see is that we tend to think about how hard something is. For instance, I need to learn to program a website. That's actually not hard for me. I've done that a million times and I've kind of like a technical person, so maybe that's not a good example for me, but let's take exercise for instance. Exercise sounds really hard. Just thinking about it makes me tired. So I keep like, I can get like in this rut in my mind, thinking about how hard it is and it tires me out. So I have learned to train my brain to think about the benefits, and whenever I go into, oh, it's so hard, I kind of switch it around, like I flip a switch and I start, oh, don't do that. Think about what this would give you. So instead of thinking about it is hard and I'm going to feel tired, I'm going to get sweaty and all of that, think about, oh, I'm going to have so much energy, I'm going to be slimmer, I'm going to feel stronger. And train your mind to not go into that loop of negative thinking, but going into a positive thinking spiral, and it will really motivate you and keep you out of that slump. Number 9, commit publicly. So none of us likes to lose face in front of others. So we'll go an extra mile just to keep our face. So if you state out your goals publicly, you kind of commit yourself even more. If it was just yourself that you told, I'm going to lose weight, well, nobody knows if you are not reaching that goal. But if you state it publicly, like in on your Facebook page or telling your friends, or maybe even making a small bet, like if I don't lose this weight by that date, I will kind of pay you, I don't know, $20 or something. So you make kind of a bet and you keep yourself accountable, and then you kind of have to. It's so much easier for your mind to not lose face and wanting to keep that promise and not to lose the bet. So commit to your goal publicly will really help you stay motivated and keep you out of that slump. Number 10, stick with it. Whatever you do, don't give up. Even if you aren't feeling motivated today or this week and you kind of feel like you've fallen off your horse, don't give up. Again, motivation is ever flow, it will come back. And always think of your life is not reaching a goal, it's the journey getting there. Actually, that is your life. That's what your life is made of. I know that you want to get to the end, you want to get accomplished, but actually learning to enjoy the journey is a life skill that will kind of feed into this motivation and getting out of a slump on a daily basis. So just stick with it. You are in this for the long run. And even if you fall off your horse, you can always, always get back up. So yeah, ride on the tide of your motivation and you will get there, I promise. So now that you've listened to my 10 strategies for getting out of a slump and getting motivated, I really hope that you go and implement and putting these strategies to work so you can get motivated to do and accomplish whatever you are trying to accomplish. I wish you a very great day and I'll see you in another video. Bye for now. Thank you for listening or watching this content. I hope it has brought you some value. I hope it's been inspiring or motivating or given you some kind of new idea to maybe get out of a rut or maybe really go and crush it. Listen, I'm just an ex-computer programmer who got into a car crash back in 2001 and took me several years to get out of that. And during that time, I studied everything there was to study about spirituality and personal growth. And finally, I found my way to finding my passion, and that is online marketing and online business building. That's the platform that I really love to help inspire people to create the life and the freedom that they want in their life and build a legacy and impact the world for the better. Now, if you want to follow me on this journey, you can find me on social media or go to my blog askmarilena.com. That's askmarilena.com. And I hope to see you in another episode. Bye for now.